Good morning, everybody. And my name is Paolo Caricato. I am working in the European Commission. I am a veterinarian and I'm working in DG Sante, who is the DG that is establishing the hygiene rules for food, in particular, I'm dealing with food of animal origin, and in particular with composite products. So the new rules that will start starting from 21st of April this year are modifying the framework of the import of composite products. So, but before to talk about that, I would like just to say what a composite product is. A composite product is a product that is mixing processed products of animal origin with vegetables. I don't know, for instance, a sandwich with ham, cheese, and salad, or a product that pizza that is containing mozzarella cheese, ham, and vegetables. This is a composite product. So when we are talking about products of animal origin that are not processed, so I mean an hamburger with fresh meat and some herbs or some vegetables, we are not talking about the composite products because the meat is fresh. So to be categorized as composite products, a product of animal origin must be processed. Just to say the big changes we had in our legislation starting from April 21st, 2021, I would like to say that these changes are based on a new risk-based approach, in the sense that today the import of composite products and the rules for the import of composite products are related to the percentage of food of animal origin contained in the products, less than 50% or more than 50%, and with the presence or not of meat inside the products. So composite products today that are containing any quantity of meat or non-shelf stable dairy products or more than 50% of products of animal origin inside are certified and controlled at the border inspection post. Products with less than 50% of products of animal origin or without meat or shelf stable with dairy products are not controlled and they are just accompanied by commercial documents. The future of the legislation is changed in the sense that we decide to have a more risk-based approach. Risk-based approach that it will be based on the shelf stability or not of the composite products. So we divided the composite products in three main categories that are non-shelf-stable composite products, shelf-stable composite products that contain meat products, and the shelf-stable composite products that don't contain meat products. So these categories will respect different rules. Before to talk about the rules that those composite products should respect, I would like to underline that the processed products of animal origin contained in the composite products is an important part of the new legislation. But there are no changes as regard the fact that The processed products of animal origin contained in the composite products must originate from countries that are authorized to export that products to the Europe, must originate from establishments that are authorized to export that products to the Union. So what we want to underline with this situation is that the rules are not changed for the raw material, in the sense that today and in the future, the products of animal origin that will be included in the composite products must originate from approved establishment and approved countries. As regards the establishment that is producing the composite products, this establishment is not an approved establishment. It will be, as today, an establishment that will be just registered by the competent authority. And we will not have a list of establishments that are producing composite products. What we want is that those establishments are under the control of the competent authorities, are listed in the national register of the competent authorities, but it's not necessary that those establishments are establishments in full compliance with the EU rules. So what we want is that the establishment that is producing the composite products is just registered, but the establishment that is producing the product of animal origin included in the composite products is approved. Another point that, in my opinion, is quite important is related to the requirements relating to the residues of chemical substances in processed products of animal origin contained in each of the three categories of composite products. So the third countries that is manufacturing the composite products will have to be listed in decision 2011-163 for each processed product of animal origin contained in composite products. This means that from the 21st April, the third country manufacturing the composite products must either have an approval for residues monitoring plan for each of the ingredients of animal origin in question, or the country has the possibility to source those products from or a country approved with the residue plan and approved to export to the Union, or the country can source the products of animal origin from a member state. In that case, the country is not necessary that they have a specific residue plan, but what they have to do is to inform the Commission, to ask the Commission to be introduced with a footnote in the decision 2011-163, and in this footnote we will put that the country is sourcing the products of animal origin included in that composite product from a member state or from an authorized country. So just to summarize the situation for residues, there will be two main situations. Or the country is authorized with with their own residue plan, or if they don't have it, it's not a problem, they can source the products of animal origin in a member state or in an approved country, and in that case they will send a request to the Commission asking to be introduced in the decision with the footnote that is explaining that this country is sourcing the raw material from an approved country. Another point that, in my opinion, is quite important is the certificate. So, starting from the 21st of April 2021, a certificate will accompany the non-shelf-stable composite products or the shelf-stable composite products containing meat. For the shelf-stable composite products, this certificate is not necessary and it will be accompanied by a private attestation that will be filled in by the importer, where it will be indicated the country of origin, the establishment where the composite products has been elaborated, the establishment from where the raw material is originating. The list of certificate has been published in Commission Implementing Regulation 2020-2235. The requirements that are present in the certificate are based on the certificate we have today. So the competent authority shall indicate the origin of the raw material, the respect of the European rules as regards the origin of the raw material, the establishment of origin, the respect of the residue plan, the respect of public and animal health rules. Because what is important is to underline that the new certificate and the certifying officer should attest in the certificate, should certify in the certificate the respect of public and animal health rules. There will be also animal health rules that shall be respected as regard the import of composite products. And as a general rule, I would like to say that there will be a big distinction between products non-shelf stable or shelf stable containing meat and products that are shelf stable. As regard the country of origin for products that are not shelf stable or they are shelf stable containing meat, the rules are quite strict in the sense that only composite products that will contain products of animal origin non-shelf stable and shelf stable containing meat can be imported into the EU only if they are originating from countries that are already authorized to export meat or to export the specific products that is contained in the composite products. Just an example. If there is a country that wants to export a composite product non-shelf stable containing eggs or containing dairy products, this country must be authorized to export eggs or dairy products to the EU because that product is not shelf stable. Or if there is a country that wants to export a composite product containing meat or containing meat shelf stable or not shelf stable, in that case, the country must be authorized to export meat to the EU. Why this? Because these rules are coming from the respect of animal health rules. The meat is considered as a very dangerous product for protecting the animal health in the EU, we are forcing a very strict, we are putting in we are establishing a very strict system of control for that. So What we want is that the composite products that are containing non-shelf stable products of animal origin or meat must have very, very strict rules. As regards the composite products that are shelf stable, in that case, the rules are easier in the sense that the products, the composite products that are shelf stable can be exported to the EU from countries that are authorized to export all fishery products or dairy products or meat products or egg products to the EU. So it is sufficient that the country that want to export composite products shelf stable is listed in one of the list of the categories I mentioned before. So if a country, if for instance Korea is listed for fishery products, Korea can import shelf stable composite products non containing meat, even if the composite products are containing eggs, for instance, processed eggs, and the composite products is shelf stable. Those products will be accompanied by a private attestation and not by a certificate. What's happened once the composite products are arriving in the EU? Which kind of control they are they have to pass? So for the composite products, once they enter into the EU, they pass to the border control post where they will be controlled. Those composite products, the control of those composite products will be different and the documents will be different. If we are talking about non-shelf stable composite products or shelf stable composite products. Non-shelf stable composite products or shelf stable composite products containing meat will be accompanied by a certificate, as I said before, and they will be controlled at the border control post. The shelf stable composite products will be accompanied by a private attestation and will be controlled at the border inspection post. So the difference in that case, it will be between the certificate and the attestation. There will be also a list of composite products considered as low risk products that will be accompanied by the private attestation, but they will not be controlled at the border inspection post. They will be controlled, if necessary, at destination. We are talking about the list of exempted products that today is included in the decision 2007-275, and in the future, in the future legislation, will be included in the new regulation that is taking into account the previous list. The new list is bigger in the sense that we are including more products that are exempted from the controls to in the border control post. For instance, milk chocolate, for instance, products containing gelatin, olives, wheat, anchovies, or products that the member states and the Commission consider as products that are not representing a real risk for the for public health and for animal health. So what is important is that this list will be published soon, and the very important issue is that that list will be bigger in comparison with the list that we have already published in the decision 2007-275. So I try to summarize the main rules of the main new rules that we have for the composite products. So what is important that you keep in mind is that first, there is the new rules are not anymore based on the percentage of products containing composite products, but they are risk-based. Risk-based means that there will be a big difference between three categories of composite products: non-shelf-stable composite products, shelf-stable composite products containing meat, and shelf-stable composite products. This is the first step. Second step, certification. Non-shelf-stable composite products and shelf-stable composite products containing meat will be accompanied by a certificate. Shelf-stable composite products will be accompanied by a private attestation. Third point, controls. Non-shelf-stable composite products and shelf-stable composite products containing meat and shelf-stable composite products will be controlled at the border control post. The difference is that one category will be accompanied by a certificate, one category will be accompanied by a private attestation. There will be a list of products, of composite products, that will not controlled at the border control post because considered as low risk products, and those products will be controlled at destination. Another point is residue. So the country that is exporting the composite products must have in place a residue plan for the composite products contained in the for the products of animal origin containing composite products. They can have a residue plan, or they can source the raw material from all a member state or an authorized country. In that case, they have just to inform the Commission that they will do, and they will be added to the decision 2011-163 with a footnote. One important point that I would like that you keep in mind is that the rules as regard the origin of the raw material didn't change, in the sense that the raw material that is included in the composite product, so the product of animal origin that is included in the composite products, must originate from countries and from establishments that are approved for the export to the Union. This is not changed. In their present rules are the same. Okay, now I would like to pass to the question I received from Korea as regards the new rules for composite products. I received a list of inquiries, and I would like to reply to the question received. This lecture and the question I receive will be sent to the organizers in written, like that you can have a document that could be a good basis for you for applying the new rules on composite products. So, the first question I received is as regard the list of third countries that will be authorized to export composite products. So it's true that in Article 12.2 of Regulation 2019-625, we said that a specific list of third countries or region authorized to export composite products to the Union will be established. So Korea is asking if we have an idea about this publication. What I would to reply is that this will not happen in the near future, because this would require a number of audits, probably focusing on the exporting countries by decreasing order of volume of export. So it's not is a project, but it's not something that will be immediate. In any case, pending the establishment of such a list, the system will rely on the categorization of composite products and on the existing list of countries, depending on the processed products of animal origin contained in the composite products and in the shelf stability. So, for the moment, the idea is to have a list of countries authorized to export composite products, but it will be something that is not for the immediate future. So, for the moment, we maintain the status quo. Another question is if the interest parties have the chance to comment about this list. I repeat, it's something that is not immediate, but in any case, the third countries will be consulted via the usual consulting mechanism we have, SPS, information to the stakeholders, etc., etc. So, in any case, the Korean authorities and the Korean stakeholders will receive information about this list once established. Another question is if we have a plan to make a list of import-approved establishment manufacturing composite products that are located in third countries. No, we don't have this idea. As I said in my lecture, the establishments that are producing the composite products are just registered under responsibility of the competent authorities. So those establishments are not requiring an EU approval unless such establishment manufacturing the composite products do process themselves the ingredients of animal origin. In that case, of course, they must be approved as any food processing establishment. But in general, as a general rule, an establishment that is manufacturing a composite product is not necessary, is not compulsory that is approved. Another question number two, is related to the requirement applicable to composite products. And the question is that if those requirements will be are referred only to the 14 HS code that are mentioned in Article 12.1 of Regulation 2019-625. I would like and no, in the sense that Article 12.1 has been modified and the proposed HS code are now 24. So the list has been expanded. The modification has been sent to the SPS, to the Sanitary and Phytosanitary Agreement, and the competent authorities have been informed. However, in my in the text that I will send to you with the replies to your question, I introduced the new code that will be covered by the new HS code. So you will have a complete list of the codes that are covering the composite products that will be covered by the new legislation. Now we are talking about the fact that Korea is exporting, has the intention to export composite products, and the fact that Korea asks to export non-shelf stable composite products containing less than 50% of dairy, etc., etc. So Korea is asking if they can export, since Korea has not been listed as a third country approved for the entry into the Union of dairy and egg products, Korea said that for them, it will not be possible to export non-shelf stable composite products containing dairy on eggs. And Korea is asking if that interpretation is correct. Yes, the interpretation is correct. If Korea is not authorized to export dairy products or egg products, Korea will not be authorized to export non-shelf stable composite products containing eggs or dairy products. For instance, another question we receive is that if Korea is manufacturing ice cream with milk, it will be possible to export ice cream with milk if Korea is not authorized to export dairy products to the EU? The reply, once again, is no. It will be not possible for Korea to export ice cream because we are talking about a composite product that is not shelf stable. And if Korea is not authorized to export dairy products to the EU, Korea will not be authorized to export ice cream containing dairy products to the EU. The third question, another question, is about the fact that Korea has not been approved to export of composite products containing meat products to the EU. But Korea said, I am using meat products from another source. I can use meat products from authorized third countries or from the European Union. May I export composite products containing meat products to the Union? If Korea is not authorized to export meat and meat products to the EU, Korea is not authorized to export composite products to the EU containing meat, shelf stable or non-shelf stable. So, in just to reply to the question, is that Korea cannot export composite products containing meat, shelf stable or not shelf stable, because it's not authorized to export meat or meat products to the EU. The same situation is applicable if Korea wants to export non-shelf stable composite products containing eggs or dairy products, because Korea is not authorized to export those products to the European Union. Another question is about the shelf stable composite products. Here the situation is different because Korea is authorized to export fishery products, for instance. So the fact that Korea is already authorized to export fishery products to the EU authorizes Korea to export shelf stable composite products containing fish, dairy or eggs to the EU. Okay, of course, they have to respect the rules on residues, but as a general reply, I would like to say that taking into account that Korea is authorized to export at least fishery products to the EU, Korea is authorized to export composite products, shelf stable, containing not only fish, but also egg and dairy. Then there is a question about the residues. So Korea is asking if which are the rules that they have to a residue control plan for the products that they are exporting, or if they don't have it, they can source the products of animal origin from other countries that have a residue plan and are authorized to export to the EU, or they can source the raw material from a member state. In that case, I would like to provide you an example, for instance. If the composite products containing dairy products and egg products is elaborated in Korea, and Korea doesn't have an approved residue monitoring plan for dairy products and for egg products, what they can do is to source the dairy and the eggs. We are talking about shelf-stable composite products, of course, from or a member state that is approved, or from a third country that is approved. In that case, Korea, what they have to do is to ask the Commission to be introduced in the decision 2011-163 with a footnote that is indicating the source of the raw material. Another question is that Korea is on the list of approved third countries for the export of fishery products and heat-treated poultry products, and has an approved residue monitoring plan. So what Korea is understanding is that the export of shelf-stable and non-shelf-stable composite products containing fishery or poultry products is authorized. Yes, I would like to reply, yes, it is authorized, because you are authorized to export fishery products and poultry products to the EU. Of course, the products, the composite products containing the poultry products, the poultry meat products into the EU, in that case, the poultry meat should be treated as imposed by the animal health legislation. So if Korea is authorized to export pasteurized milk meat, they have to export meat that is treated with that treatment. If it's authorized to export sterilized meat, the treatment will be that one, and the same for other commodities. But as a general rule, yes, it is possible. Another issue, another point, another question that is once again about the residue. Yes, so Korea is asking if processed products of animal origin other than meat products containing the shelf-stable composite products manufactured in Korea are sourced from a member state, so in Europe, or approved establishment located in third country, should Korea also be listed in annex to decision 2011-163? The reply is yes, so you will be listed, but with a footnote. So it's very easy. You have just to ask the Commission to be introduced and to have this footnote that is explaining that you are sourcing the raw material from authorized member states or from authorized third country. How it works is very easy. A letter to the Commission, to Directorate F of the DG SAMPE, where you ask for this introduction, and it will be introduced, Korea will be introduced, and twice per year we will modify the list of the third countries that are authorized. So if you have the intention to source raw materials from member states or from third countries authorized, please ask for the introduction of your country, of Korea, in the list of the countries that are using this footnote, that are sourcing the raw material from countries that are authorized. Question number four. Shelf stable for shelf stable and non-shelf stable composite products containing processed products of animal origin other than meat products, do all the establishment producing processed products of animal origin have to get an approval from the EU, regardless of the percentage of ingredients of animal origin, even the content in less than 1%? Yes. So now the approach is changed. We don't care if the content is more or less than 1%, 2%, 10%, 10%. What we want is, but there are not new rules, that all the establishment that are providing the raw material to the establishment that are producing the composite products be approved. So the establishment must be approved independently from the percentage of processed products of animal origin contained in the final composite products. This requirement, I want really to underline that point. These requirements are not new. They are required since 2006. So when the food hygiene legislation, the regulation F3/2004 was applicable. So what I mean is that each product of animal origin that is contained in the composite products, and is no matter about the percentage, must originate from countries and established that are approved. There is an example. The instant noodle comes with a seasoning packet of squid powder, 4%. When calculating the content of squid powder against a serving of instant noodle, the content of squid powder stands less than 0.5%. Then, those establishments manufacturing such squid powder have to get an approval from the EU? The reply is yes. Yes, for the reasons that I explained before. It's not important the percentage. What is important is that the establishment is approved. When vegetable extract contained in bean paste composite products has negligible amount of fishery products, which of the following establishment is subject to the approval to the EU for export? The question is vegetable extract manufacturing facility or fishery products manufacturing facility or both of them. The reply is fishery products only. So we don't care about the establishment that are producing vegetables extract, because they are not covered by our legislation. They have just to respect the general hygiene rules. But the establishment that are producing products of animal origin must be approved. So in the example in question 4.1, the reply is that only the establishment that is producing the composite products must be approved. Question number 5. If Korea imports fishery products or processed fishery products from EU-listed establishment in third countries and reprocess such products to make composite products, does the establishment reprocessing fishery products have to get an approval from the EU? Yes, it is compulsory. So it's not once you import fishery products or processed fishery products, even from the EU, and you are reprocessing it, the establishment that is carrying out the reprocess must be approved. It's compulsory. Question number 6. A new listed establishment manufactured processed fishery products using seasoning with negligible amount of fishery products. And this seasoning is produced as the non-EU listed establishment. When this EU-listed establishment wanted to export fishery products to the EU, is the seasoning manufacturing establishment also be approved by the EU? Yes, the seasoning establishment should have been approved even before the 21st of April, because, as I said, the establishment that are exporting directly or indirectly to the Union must be approved. And those rules are in place since at least 2004. So what is important is to understand that all the products of animal origin that are destined to be exported to the EU must originate from approved countries and approved establishments. The last question is regarding the official certificate. So the question is that when using products of animal origin originating from member states or third countries or regions thereof authorized to the entry into the EU, it would be difficult for the competent authorities in Korea to demonstrate the compliance with, for instance, animal health requirement. So the question is, Korea will be exempt from demonstrating such requirements in the official certificate? I have to reply that the certificate has been already published in Regulation 2020-2235. So the rules are there. The official veterinarian or the certifying officer must attest the origin of the processed animal products, including the composite products, filling in the necessary part of the certificate where those guarantees are requested. So country of origin, approved establishment, etc. So my reply is there are the country is not exempted. You have just to introduce in the certificate the origin of the raw material, the origin of the country, the origin of the establishment. So we have to be sure that the products of animal origin that are included in the composite products are in full respect with the European rules that are foreseen today. So this was the last question. As I said before, all the questions and my lecture will be sent to the organizers in written, so it will be possible to translate the request, the lecture, and the replies to your questions in Korean. Like that, it will be easier for everybody to have, I hope, a clear picture of the new situation. It was a real pleasure for me to stay with you today. I hope that this lecture was useful. And in any case, the organizers have my contact. They have the contact, they have my email. So in case of doubt, you can always contact me, and it will be a pleasure for me to reply to your question. Thank you very much. And I hope that this lecture will be useful for you. Thank you very much.